Alright, in this short tutorial, we're gonna learn how you can import your collected GPS data into ArcMap. So, this is the map of BW, or actually it's part of the BW campus, and is your study area. So here is the Maliki Center and Reader Library, and it's a very small study area. And here is my plan. So my plan for collecting the data across the study area. So notice that I spread out the points across the image. If you look at the points that I considered for collect, and also notice most of the points were collected in the borders of the image and also in the intersections, because I wanted to have a higher accuracy for the next lab or for georeferencing. So and also here is my points that I collected. So I put the GPS on point number one, and here is the X, here is the Y. If you know the description of the location, so for example for location number one, it's close to Reader Library, can mention that for the future references. Maybe you need to go back to the point and collect the point again. So you can provide some description here. So here are my X, Y, based on the GPS, based on the datum and datum WGS84 and the UTM as the map projection, zone 17N, zone 17 north for the Ohio. So I'm going to import these points into the GPS. So you are familiar with importing the data with latitude and longitude, right? So importing the data with X and Y is even easier than the latitude and longitude. So if you open up your ArcMap and then load this CSV file. So if your data is in the Excel format, you have to save it as a CSV. And then, because CSV is more compatible with GIS, and then add this CSV into GIS. So here is my which one, points underscore BW, and here just right click on the CSV file, display XY. So your X field is X, your Y field is Y, and here you also have to define the coordinates. So if you click on edit, so the values are based on the meters, right? So where they were not based on the latitude or longitude. So we have to go to the projected coordinate system, and then UTM as map projection, and WGS84 as the datum, northern hemisphere. And for the our study area is in the zone 17 north of the UTM. Then click OK and OK. And okay, and then click yes. So here are the location of my points. You can label the points, for example, based on the point number. You can label the points, then apply okay. And so here are my points, but this is temporary. You can easily export them and make a shape file of the GPS point in lab 7 folder with the name of GPS points and data type of shapefile. Save and OK. Now we can remove the CSV and the event file. So here are my points. Again, you can edit, you can label the features based on which field, based on the point number. Okay, so here I started from point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. So you need to collect between 15 to 20 points. If you want to make sure that you have done a good job, you can this is also called validation, comparison with reality. You can add the base map and then click add, and then compare it how good is the points in terms of the collected points, how close they are to the reality. So here you can see that. So here is my point number one, point number two. So you can see that it's not exactly in the same location, because GPS has accuracy of GPS, it has less than 5 meter error in the location. But you can see that almost very close to the locations that I put my GPS there. So 18, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and also 6. You can see that. So these points are both visible on the image and also on the ground. Okay. 9 is almost, yes, in the middle of here. I put the GPS in the middle of here. And if you want to see better see this image, you can. If you want to better see the points, you can right click on the image properties and then go to the display tab and increase the transparency of the layer, maybe to 40%. Apply. Okay, so you can see the points. So the GPS points kind of line up with the reality.